मैं दिखता हूँ स्वीट इनोसेंट स्वामी टाइप का, लेकिन एक्चुअली वो बहुत बड़े You know, I honestly feel it's not just the film industry. I think that's the way the world is moving today, and that's where the world is moving today. If you ask me whether it's right or wrong, I honestly don't have an answer. I think it's really amazing that when you have a relationship with one person and then that goes on, it's nurtured and you form a good base for that.
What is your mantra?
What's my mantra?
What is Varun Dhawan's mantra?
That you have one person in my life and be committed to that one person.
Do you have that one person in your life that you're committed to in your life?
Do I have that one person in my life? I think I've had that one person for a long time, and
okay.
I think that's my mother. I love her a lot. But I don't know if I have a life partner as in.
But a partner.
Because I mean, I've not decided to get married. Yeah. But there is someone that I really, really care about. My first relationship was when I was in college, in HR college. I started dating this girl, and that went on for like 4 months or so, and then she kind of. Cheated on me and
wow. So wait over here. How did you take that? When somebody cheated on you, how did you take
it? So I mean, growing up in a Hindi film family, I was pretty filmy. So I still remember the time when that happened. I wanted to go through heartbreak because I would always listen to this. Like as an artist, there are 9 emotions. And you to get that one emotion, you have to get your heart broken. I was a kid, man. I was like 14, I was 16 or something. So I was like, so now this has happened. Now what do I do? And I would just go and stand under the shower and let the water fall on me. I would wash my face and I would look at myself. Because I was like, you know, if I have to, I knew I wanted to be an actor. So I was like, I have to use this emotional memory someday in a scene. And I have to get this thing back. But the girl messed it up, yeah, because then she left that guy and then she wanted to come back to me. And I was like, no, don't do this. Don't mess with my emotional memory because I need this memory to act. Don't make me go back to you now. I'm not going to name the girl.
Excuse me.
Because, I mean, you should never kiss and tell. But it was, I was, I think, 13 years old.
13 years old.
13 years old. I'm saying like a proper kiss, like a French kiss, like a proper, like all out there. So it was in the back of her building. And for some reason, I had behaved like, you know, like, I know this. I know how to do it. I've seen it in the movies. I'd seen Titanic and stuff. So I was like,
Acha.
I know I'm going to do this. I'm going to like be able to do this very easily. And I got so nervous when it was about to happen with this girl. Eventually, she just caught me and she said, what are you doing? And then she just went for it. And yeah, then it happened.